שיר למעלות תשעינה אל הרים מאין יבוא עזרי
Birshut Morei v'Rabotei with the permission of Hashem. Well, as you know, before you want to say something with connection with the Torah, always there is a Yetzara. Always the Yetzara is fantastic, is fabulous. When it comes to Advar Torah, it's something happened. But Baruch Hashem, that we, even that we don't see each other, but we can see a small Advar Torah. And the parasha of this week, it's Bamidbar. But the name of Bamidbar is the desert. That means the Torah explained that Hashem is spoke to Moshe Rabbeinu in the desert of Sinai the second year after the Jews left Egypt. A lot of details. In the desert, and the desert of Sinai, and the second year after the Jews left Egypt. All this need to be understanding. I mean, usually the Torah, it's very, very short. The Torah don't talk too much. When the Torah talk about a story, it makes the story short. When the Torah talk about Matan Torah, can you imagine what it is Matan Torah? Ay, ay, ay. And it was very, very short. All the preparation was very, very short. When the Torah talk about mitzvot, as well, the Torah is very short. Like there is thousands of laws about Shabbat, but the Torah writes only few words. Keep Shabbat. Don't put the light on. You know, Hashem created the world in 6 days, the seventh day rested. So, very, very short. Usually the Torah, this, otherwise, if the Torah it's longer, so you need billions of books. Billions of books. So here the Torah, we don't understand why the Torah, she's so short, so long, about the, when it talk about this parasha of Bamidbar. Let's see all of us the pasuk. The pasuk said like that. וידבר השם אל משה, and השם spoke to משה, במדבר סיני, and the desert of סיני, באוהל מועד, and the tabernacle, לחודש השני, the second month, בשנה השנית, the second year, that the Jews came out from Egypt. And what is the discussion? השם said to משה רבינו, count the Jews. Count the Jews. I mean, the Torah should be short. The Torah should say, and Hashem spoke to Moshe, as usual, and tell him, count the Jews. That's it. That's it. See, oh, it goes, kol adat mi Yisrael, mishpichotayim libet avotam, count out each head of the family, and that's it. Why all these details? Why? My friend, where exactly few days before Matan Torah? You have to know one thing. The Zohar HaKadosh said, Hashem created a lot of worlds. Bara olamot v'chribam. He created a lot of planets. I mean, all what you see, all those planets that you see, billions of planets, Hashem, he created billions and billions of billions of billions of planets, and then Hashem destroyed them. He did a big bang here, a big bang here, big bang here, bam, 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 bam. And every time Hashem, he destroyed all those planets. Every time. Until he decided to create this world that where we live. The earth, the moon, the sun, and all, you know, all this, those galaxies that you see today. And that, there is something that we have to understand. Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu need it to create the world? All those planets to destroy them? I mean, Hashem, don't tell me that Hashem has nothing to do. Hashem, every second of Hashem, he can do a lot of things. I mean, if Hashem decided to create those worlds, it's something that we should learn. This corona that we have today, do you think Hashem has nothing to do just to send the corona to the people? Do you think Hashem has nothing to do? Huh? Just to make people to suffer? No. There is a reason for this corona. Don't forget, there was an epidemic, the Spanish epidemic. There were 50 million people die. 50. And there is the black epidemic. The black epidemic, it was nearly 200 million people die. 200 million people die in the black epidemic a few hundred years ago. So, Baruch Hashem, this epidemic of corona, thanks God, it's global, it's all the world is affected. But Baruch Hashem, thanks God, Baruch Hashem, it didn't do a lot of damage, Baruch Hashem. Of course, people are a little bit revolting. Yes, yeah, why? There is nothing you can do. We have to decide. I mean, God forbid. Can you imagine the black epidemic, the Spanish epidemic, how many millions of people died? This time, Baruch Hashem, only we are at about 300,000 or 400,000 people that die, but not millions. Has v'shalom, God forbid. But you have to know that Baruch Hashem, today there is more. Look, I'm talking about myself. Today, Baruch Hashem, there is more mitzvot, there is more Torah, there is more emunah, and then Baruch Hashem that reduce. And today with the communication, so when we have to pray for somebody, so everybody is praying for him. We know a lot of people that die, nearly die. They were a few seconds before they die. And Baruch Hashem, they woke up. Because today, Baruch Hashem, with the communication, so we pray, brachot, bradan, dan, dan, dan. There is today Ahavat Israel. Every day we receive names, hundreds of names. I receive maybe more than 20,000 names. Can you imagine? Jewish, non-Jewish, Arabs, Chinese, all names for brachot. I mean, we receive, every day we receive brachot. I mean, today, never in any generation that they were more in contact like today. You have no, you cannot imagine how many people are helping each other, and even that people don't work. There's a lot of chesed, a lot of chesed. And Baruch Hashem, this corona is supposed to be very, very, very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. And Baruch Hashem, it did not affect, of course, it affected businesses, it affected people don't work, it affected a lot of things, but it did not affect lives, like the Spanish epidemic and the black epidemic. 200 million people, nearly all year. I saw on the paper, the newspaper, that 1 out of 3 died. 1 out of 3 people died 300 years ago. Nearly all Europe was empty from people. And Baruch Hashem, this one that's supposed to be aggressive one? No, Baruch Hashem, because of the tefillot, because of a commitment of Torah, mitzvot, ma'asim tovim. You know, Pekei Avot, it said, when you don't respect the Shemitah, when you don't do tzedakah, there is epidemic. Ah, Caesar, you showed me the Pekei Avot. Yes, Caesar, yes. That's what the Pekei Avot said. Any kind of epidemic comes when there is no tzedakah, when there is no, when here in Israel we don't respect Shemitah. But Baruch Hashem, here in Israel, people respect Shemitah. They respect it. Most of them respect it. Those who don't respect, they don't know. We are not allowed to judge them. We are not allowed to judge somebody that he doesn't do a mitzvah. They don't know. But usually people here in Israel, Baruch Hashem, they do. They do Shemitah. But still, that's why Baruch Hashem here in Israel, this corona, it did not affect too much the people here, Baruch Hashem. We only had 250 people pass away, die. But of course, it's because when you respect Shemitah, and when you do tzedakah, so Hashem protects. Tzedakah tzatzim emavet. And Baruch Hashem, the Jewish people, when they do tzedakah not only for the Jewish people, they do tzedakah for the whole world. So the whole world will not be affected. When I do tzedakah, I pray for Argentina, I pray for Brazil, I pray for Africa, I pray for everybody, Jewish and not Jewish, I pray for everybody. Even I pray for the animals, because the animals are a decoration of this world. Hashem, he created the animals as a decoration. And so we need to pray for them. You need to pray for animals to remain alive, to the people to remain alive. But one thing, my friend, I want to understand. This parasha of Bamidbar, before Matan Torah, I don't understand why the Pasuk is long. Why a lot of details? I mean, the Torah usually is short. The Torah should be short. And Hashem spoke to Moshe and tell him, count the Jews. Count the families. That's it. Why we need all these details? Hashem spoke to Moshe in the desert of Sinai and the tabernacle and the first day of the first of Iyar. And the second year since the Jews left Egypt. Why I needed all this? Why? What for? What it is the reason? Why? My friend, few minutes ago, we did ask a question as following. Hashem created planets and destroyed them. So our question was, why Hashem needed to create all those kind of planets and to destroy them? Hashem, you don't need. Why to? What is the reason? I mean, Hashem knows that those planets, they will not resist, so he don't need to create them. I mean, just imagine. I build a house and I destroy it and I build another house. I destroy it and build and have a lot of plans. And I know I have the real plan. So why are we not? It will be intelligent that all the plans that they are not, they are weak, that they are not suitable, to put them away, to throw them, and to use the right plan and to build a house. Why Hashem? He had to do all this. My friend, Hashem, we want to show you something. He did not create only one world. A lot. How many? I don't know. Or what our rabbi said, Bara olamot v'hirban. Hashem, he created a lot of world, maybe billions, I don't know. I don't know how How long could the time? I don't know. You know, Hashem is illimited. Hashem has no. We cannot. We have nothing to say about Hashem. We can talk about age, but when you talk about Hashem, we say Hu Rishon, He is the first, He is the last. That's it. There is nothing to ask. So we want to know why, my friend. Hashem, He wants to teach you that all the olamot that He created them without the Torah. Without the Torah. I would just to ask you a question. If you want to build a house and you don't put the cement with the sand, I mean, this house, it will not resist, because you need something to hold the cement. You need something to make the construction strong, to stick, you know. If you just put the sand, it will fail. Just imagine if you don't put the steel, you know, and the construction. If there is no foundation, a small earthquake, all the building will fall. Just imagine today there is buildings of 1,000 meters high. If there is no foundation, and 1 second, a little bit of wind, a storm, all that building will fall up, will be destroyed. So you need, according to what you build, you need a strong foundation. And the foundation is the Torah. Hashem, He created a lot of words, all kinds of words, all kinds. He used the best material. The best of the best. But Hashem wants to show you, see, my friend, you see, Hashem wants to teach us, without the Torah, the world cannot stand. Ha'olam omed al Torah ve'al Avodah ve'al Gemut Hasadim. So when He created this world, the Zohar said, Istakel be'oraita o'bara alma, like an architect. The architect, you know, a lot of architects, I remember when I was building the yeshiva of Ashdod, I saw there a lot of books with 10 architects with big papers open, looking, bam, bam. Baruch Hashem, today I am building one of the biggest synagogue in Israel today, in Ashdod. I am in the middle of building it, in the middle. Even during the corona, I did not stop. We started, Baruch Hashem, 6 months ago. We did not stop. We carry on building, even that the situation is very tough. I have emunah b'tachon HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I don't stop. So my friend, I know that I'm not doing that for myself, because I am 70 years old. Till maybe 20, but I do it for Am Israel. There is a lot of people living. They need a synagogue, so here is a synagogue for you, for them. It's a big project of $10 million, and with emunah and bitachon. I mean, today a synagogue and a bit of midrash, it's crazy. You have to be mad. Yes, we are mad for Hashem. We know that the world cannot stand without the Torah. That is the teaching. This is what Hashem wants to teach us. That without the Torah, the world cannot stand. Ha'olam omed al Torah. The world stands with the Torah. Avodah, it's the tefillah, pray. And gemil hasadim, tzedakah. Without those three things, there is nothing left. the world will be destroyed. The world cannot be controlled. You know, the Gemara said, if the non-Jew people knows how much the Torah is good for them, it's good for the world, they will sponsor all the synagogues that we build. They will sponsor all the people who study Torah. They will sponsor everything. But they don't know. Because the Torah only believes I receive it. They didn't receive, so they don't know. So my friend, this is the reason why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he built it, he created world to destroy them. A message. You see, I create them without the zechut of the Torah, so they couldn't stand. My friend, just imagine, I don't know if you have a telescope. If you have a telescope, you will see a lot of stars every day that they are born, star is born, and you have few stars that they are destroyed. They collapse. Why this world, it remained? Tell me why. Why this earth where we live, it remained? Why? 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 What's the difference between all of them? Why the sun will not burn the world? You know, if the sun only move a little bit from his trajectory, he will destroy, he will burn the world. If he will go a little bit far away from the earth, the earth will be cold, it's finished. Because Hashem created this world with the Torah. And Hashem created the sun and the moon and the stars that this world needed to maintain with the Torah. Like an architect, he looked the plan and he built. So Hashem, he was looking the plan, the Torah, and he built. Yes, sir. Now you understand that Hashem created the world for Adam, for the man. That's why Adam HaRishon was, Hashem created Adam HaRishon the last. Why Hashem created Adam HaRishon the last? Why? Why not in the beginning? Why not in the first day? You know why? Because the first day, Hashem wants to show the man that all, why Hashem created the man on Friday, on the sixth day, because of the sixth of Sivan, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to give him the Torah. Hashem sent a message to Adam. Adam, all what I created for you, it's like, Baruch Hashem, you work all Friday, and Baruch Hashem, you come home, and your wife, she already prepared for you the whole Shabbat. All Shabbat is ready. It's just what you do. You go to the bathroom, you have a wash, and you go to shul, you come back to home, and your wife, she takes the table, you see a beautiful Shabbos table. Wow! That's exactly what Hashem did to Adam HaRishon. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he wanted Adam HaRishon to find everything ready for him. He created the whole world for him. He told him, Adam, all what I did is for you. Just respect Torah and mitzvot, and all this is yours. And if you want to maintain them, so respect Torah and mitzvot. This is, Rabotai, a message. A spectacular message. That without the Torah, all the words that he created, they collapse. They've been destroyed. Because there was no Torah there. It's a message for us. So, Hashem said, my friend, on Matan Torah, Hashem paralyzed the world. Can you tell me why? Why I should be paralyzed the world? You know why? Because at that moment, Hashem, you have to listen to this. Even when Hashem, he said, Anuchi, I am, the Gemara said, Nafshi, Nafshi yatz'a bedabero, it's in Shir HaShirim. When Hashem, he said, I am Hashem, all the Jews die. All, they pass away. For a few seconds, they die. Why they die? So the Torah said to Hashem, if the whole Jews die, what about me? Who's gonna read me? Who's gonna respect me? What's this? Suddenly, the Malachim, the angels came back, and they revived all the Jewish people. Hashem wanted to tell them, it's a message for the Jewish people, that the Torah, it's mechaye. Torah can put you alive. Chaim is the life. As long as you are alive, you can do, you can work, you can do Torah mitzvot. Once you're not here, it's finished. The Torah is only here, not up there. Up there, there is nothing. Up there, there is no mitzvot. Up there is only reward. The good things you did in this world, I shall pay you back up there. What? We don't know. What kind of payment? Money, of course, it's not. Money, no. No. So what? So, it's something that we don't know. Ein lo ra'ata. There is no eyes who saw. What kind of reward? Of course, it's a spiritual reward. It's not a material reward. It's something very, very spiritual. Of course, I know all what has been doing, your parents, may Hashem rest their life, their soul in peace. All what they did during their life. So, they take and especially you follow their steps. So, Hashem pay them up there. What? How? We don't know. What one thing is sure. Hashem, at the moment that he said, I am Anuchi, I am Hashem, everybody die. And then Hashem give them back life back. That means Hashem want to send them a message that real life is Torah. Without Torah, you are considered like dead people. Only through Torah. Torah, keeping Torah, mitzvot, eating kosher, putting tefillin. Live as a Jew. This is the Torah. The Torah is not to open the book all day. No. The Torah is to love your neighbor. If you love your neighbor, you love your friend, you help him, it's like you respect the whole Torah. Can you imagine? Rabbi Akiva said, You love your friends, you help them with a good advice. This like if you did the whole mitzvot. Can you imagine that? You respect Shabbat, it's like you study Torah all your life. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? Anyone who respects Shabbat, it's like he's like Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Like he studied the whole Torah, like he did everything. It's amazing. I mean, you do one mitzvah and Hashem you consider the mitzvah like you're the big rabbi of the world. It's not, this is Torah. It's like you put $1 in the casino and you win billions of dollars with $1. This is Leavdil Shabbat. So that way, on Matan Torah, when Hashem gave the Torah to the Bnei Israel, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he took their life away for a few seconds. to tell them, till now, without Torah, I consider you like dead people. But now, from now on, with the Torah, you live. So that's why he took their life, he gave them back life. Etz chayim hin lamachazikim ba. The tree of Torah. The Torah, it's like a tree. Etz chayim hin. A man, we compare a man as a tree. You know why? Because a tree, if you don't give him water, the tree will die. So the man too. The man, he has to drink water. Water is the Torah. V'el mayim el ha-Torah. Without Torah, you are nothing. My grandfather, Rabbi Chaim Vital, alav shalom, said, the same way that the body cannot live without food, the neshama, the soul, cannot live without Torah. So for the body, we give food. We feed the body with the food. But what about the neshama? The neshama, we feed the neshama with the Torah. Keeping Torah mitzvot, eating kosher, nida, I work, I don't steal, I give tzedakah. So, you don't need to open the book all day, no. You respect Shabbat. Baruch Hashem, you study from time to time. Even 10 minutes a day, it's very good. But live as a Jew. You live as a Jew, you're fantastic. So now, my friend, Hashem, he paralyzed the world when he gave the Torah. So, I told you before, two things happened. Hashem, he paralyzed the world and the soul of the Jews left the body, they died. So we explain what happened, why, what was the message about the body, about the neshama that left the body, did come back. Now, why Hashem paralyzed the world? You know why? Because Hashem wanted to give the world in the hand of the Jewish people. He told them, oh, look, till now, the world remained without the Torah. From now on, Olam Omed Al Torah. From now on, the world without the Torah will be destroyed. So he is now the keys of the world. It belongs to you. So this is Matan Torah. This is Shavuot. And that's where we prepare ourselves. We prepare ourselves today for Shavuot. Because every year, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem, he give us this. He renew the responsibility. It's like you renew the rent of your house, or you renew the rent of a factory that you, because all what we have here today, it's a loan. It's a loan from Hashem. Nothing belongs to us. Nothing. The pasuk said, "Ki li kol ha'aretz." The land belongs to Hashem. Nothing. Okay, we do real estate, we buy. Yes, okay, you buy, but nothing belongs to you. So every year we renew this kind of law, the loan of the Torah. Because the Torah, Hashem gave us the Torah a few thousand years ago. But every year, there is more Torah that Hashem can give you. And the more Hashem sees there is a demand for the Torah, so the more there is bracha, because when the Torah comes, the Torah brings with her the bracha. That's what people don't understand. My wife, she made a message for women. And she was very, 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 very tough. And that in her message, she told to the ladies, I will send you this message if you want, but it's in French. She said, I mean, this corona, it's a message. Hashem expects something from us. I mean, this corona, it didn't come for nothing. It came for something. Hashem needs us to change, to take a commitment. Why? If somebody, his life is in danger, and the doctor tell him, you need to do a surgery. But there is a 50% success, 50% no success. But if you don't do it, you die. I mean, we take the risk. I mean, 50-50, he will take the risk. He will do it. When you see this corona, it's so risky. Why? We know that this corona came for a reason, because the Gemara said if an epidemic came because there is bad things that we do, because there is not, because maybe we don't keep our eyes clean. Maybe we eat what we should not eat. Why we don't open our eyes? I mean, it's a message. Do we want things free? Hashem, now we show you I'm the boss. Can you imagine if that will remain, God forbid, it will be dangerous. So we pray to Hashem. But it's not enough just to pray to Hashem. You have to do commitment. Yes, commitment. A small commitment. So what? This is a Jew. If we don't do commitment now that we need to do it, we need Hashem to help. So when we'll do it? Till it will be late? A lot of people with problems, they call me, Rabbi, would you advise me? I have a problem. My husband, my child, dad. What kind of commitment can I take? You know what I tell them? Take all. If you ask me, if you didn't ask me, so take any commitment. That now that you ask me, how can I tell you do that or do this or do this? Do everything. If you ask me, if you say that you want to do a commitment, so you have to do a real one. That means that you understand that you are wrong in your life. So you have to do something. Yeah, so do everything. My friend, you have to know, when we were a few thousand years ago in the mountain of Sinai, we did, all of us, all the Jewish people of Argentina, because this show that I give is for our friends from Argentina, all of you, you were there in Matan Torah, and all of you did a commitment to Hashem. You said, Na'aseh v'nishma. Not only the people that they were there. Till Mashiach will come, all the people of the world, all the Jewish people from each country, Brazil, Argentina, France, Europe, Asia, America, Australia, Africa, Middle East, they all took this commitment. Na'aseh v'nishma. We'll do, we'll listen. So every year we renew Na'aseh v'nishma. Every year it's Shavuot. And every year we renew. We do and we listen. And the most important thing is, Hashem did not give us the Torah till we were all united. Like one person, with one heart. Now you understand, my friend. In the parasha of Bamidbar, we ask a question before. Hashem spoke to Moshe in the desert of Sinai, in the temple, Be'ol Moed, the first day of the second month, that means Iyar, that means Rosh Chodesh Iyar, the second year after they came out from Egypt. All this for what? Count them. Count them. Count the Jews. My friend, this is our problem. Do we count them? Do we count? Do I care about somebody else? We care about our family. We care about our parents, about our children, our close friends. Do we care about others? Today there is Corona. Maybe today there is people who need to eat. Do we care about them? I received a letter from the chief rabbi of Buenos Aires, Rab Shreba, that they need tzedakah. There is a lot of aniyim. I think Rabbasuli sent me the letter from Rab Shreva, from the committee. There is a lot of aniyim. And I think it's a responsibility for all of us that everyone should do a commitment to try to help. Because with Corona, Baruch Hashem, we don't go out. But for Hashem, we manage to have food. What about those who have no food? Ways they have to love your neighbor like yourself. And this is Matan Torah. I mean, can you imagine? We will arrive in Matan Torah and Hashem will tell you, you want the Torah? But you came only with your family. Where are the others? They are not connected with you. You're only alone. What about the others? So, my friend, it's very important. This is the time for me to tell you about this letter that I received 2 weeks ago. And he told me to talk to some people. But I don't want to talk to nobody. I make it now, you know, official. That really, you have to say what people can do for those aniyim. Because I never received a letter like that. I'm sure there is a lot. So it's very important to think of them. Very, very important. I will be the first one as well to give something. Be'ezat Hashem. Hashem, he is very much concerned about the counting of the Jewish people. Hashem is so much, and Hashem, he don't need to ask Moshe count them. Hashem, he knows how many they are. But because Hashem, he loved them so much, Hashem, he want Moshe, please, like you count diamonds. Count. And discounting, to do discounting, so the Torah writes, give a, you know, kavod to that counting. That counting was in the desert, and the Sinai, and the temple, the first day of Iyar, the second year of all this for what? For the counting of the Jews. It's like when you give a direction to somebody, like a GPS. When the GPS, before she show you a big cart. Why the GPS need to show you all the big cart? Because at least that you will see where you are situated, where you are. This is, my friend, all this drasha that I give you, just to explain this beautiful pasuk of the parasha of Bamidbar. So if Hashem give compliment to the Jews, and Hashem, to count them, he wrote a lot, a big pasuk with a lot of sign. With a lot of ways where that happened and when that happened, in which area, where, boom! To show you how much HaKadosh Baruch Hu love us. So if Hashem love us, so we have to love each other. I mean, Hashem, He don't love only the tribe of Reuben, or Shimon, or Levi, or Yehuda. No, all of them. We are Ashkenazim, Sfaradim, we are Moroccan, we are from Buenos Aires, we are this, we are, but we are not divided. We are one. We have one Torah, one God, and we are one. This is the message of this Pasuk. This is the message of Matan Torah. And this is the message why Hashem He let this world on. Because of the Torah and because of those who will study Torah and who they will maintain the world. And now we know that in Matan Torah, with no exception, all of them die when Hashem said, I am. And after, Hashem resuscitated them. He put them alive. And I would like, my friend, to finish with this beautiful story of Emuna. Last week, we received, there was a man that the doctors, he catch the corona, really, the virus. I mean, it was finished. And his wife, she called me. She told me, Rabbi, if my husband die, what's going to happen with all my family? The business is closed. I don't know where is his money. He never put his money in the bank. Maybe he has some account. We know nothing about him. I have 10 children. All what I know, I have to pay loans. But I don't know where his money. What about us? But you know, Rabbi, I don't care about money. I don't care about nothing. We want him back. Because if he's not here, our children, they will not follow Torah and Mitzvot. Because he was the one who handled the house with religion. And the children, they followed what he teach the children. The children follow him. And if something happened to him, the family will collapse. So, Rabbi, I don't want Hashem to give me back my husband for me. I want him to come back for the Torah. So that Torah will remain in my house. And she was crying. And I was crying too when she was talking to me like that. I said, Madam, the way how you've been talking, I'm sure Hashem will listen to you. I'm sure. On Friday, he opened his eyes. She called me. She told me, Rabbi, she was so excited. My Har Sinai is alive. The Torah can come back to my house. Rabbi, thank you to Hashem. We love so much Hashem. We believe so much in Hashem. Thank you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Thank you, thank you. This story, it's not finished yet. At the end, you know what she told me? Rabbi, what about the others that they are still in the coma and they are still not well? Why they will not come back as well home? So I told her, so pray for them. Now you have an experience. Now you know how to deal with Hashem. The same way you did a deal with Hashem for your husband, do it for others. We are with you. My friend, I would like to wish you Baruch Hatzlacha. God bless you. Thank you very much. And I'm sorry that I cannot see your face. I see only my face. It's funny. But Be'ezat Hashem, we do our best this week if you want. We're all home. I don't care that we do another show. And Javier, Cesar, Gustavo, Slilat, all of you, I'm sorry, I don't know the names because I don't see no face, nothing. All what I can wish you is that good health, Shalom Bayit, Parnassa, your family should grow. Thank you very much. Take care.
Adonai ishmor cha mikol ra, ishmor et nafshecha. Adonai ishmor tzedcha uvoecha. Me'ata.